Good evening. Hi. We are back at Universal Studios tonight because there's more updates for Halloween Horror Nights. It's approaching right around the corner, so we are so hyped.
We're like 2.5-3 weeks away.
And there's only about 4 houses that have been announced. So we're just like anticipating when they're gonna open up more houses or announce more houses and scare zones and everything. But there's a lot more updates in New York, I think, and the main area over by Minions.
Yeah. Yep. There, San Francisco, like a lot of places right now where things are just popping up, but no word about them. So
we're gonna go check that out, and we want to show you guys and come along with us.
Yes.
Let's go.
Let's go.
All right, so down the main walkway, you can already see some lighting trusses set up. There's a lot of pumpkins along the side too, which is kind of fitting to the whole traditional Halloween theme. So I'm really excited to see what this is going to be. But to be honest, I have no idea, I mean, what the actual like idea is.
Yeah, I refuse to reference the spec map today. I want to look at it and take it all in. Tradition is what it shouts. Lots of speakers, lots of clips for signs, lots of pumpkins. I bet in like 2 days we're gonna see like aggressive growth on lights. Yeah, I don't know.
And one other thing that we noticed was actually speakers along the wooden like blockade for the Minions ride. But there's a lot of speakers just kind of set up on the outside right here, so that makes me feel like there's gonna be a lot of action in this area as well.
Yeah, either action or just trying to cancel out what's going on for the construction behind the scenes to keep you kind of forgetting what's going on behind those walls. I don't know if they're going to keep these Minions up or not, but it doesn't feel very HHN friendly. But we'll see. You never know with HHN and Universal, but I don't know. I like that their speakers still like add ambiance for sure.
Okay, so we're on our way to New York, but we noticed that there's some food booths actually set up right over here. This is the same area.
I haven't seen it lit up like this.
That they had the Texas Chainsaw food last year. So this looks incredible though. Seeing up there, you have the, I guess, demons or ghosts that have their hands kind of just, you know, and faces pressed up against the glass. There's someone reaching out right there. This is very poltergeist-ish.
I can say Poltergeist, Haunting a Hill House.
Poltergeist, Haunting of Hill House, very reminiscent of that. So this is actually going to be really cool.
Yeah. I mean, that just, it's setting the mood, though, for what this could be. This looks like orangey red. It says trick-or-treat. So I'm assuming this would be like purple, orange, keeping with that traditional Halloween theme that we want so bad. I'm itching to get these menus. We haven't seen anything yet, so hopefully soon enough we'll see those.
But this, I mean, already just puts you in the mood of Halloween, October 31st. I cannot wait to see what they do with all of this. This is going to be amazing.
Yeah, it looks like a nice, like, ghost, almost ghost town. Because there's, like, the brick and the stone. No, like, true theme yet, but it just, I don't know. It looks really good so far. Very big and grand. And then, I guess, behind us, really quick, you can see the Transformers queue bar, which I always like to see that they do something there. It's always really nice and big.
Is always a busy area for drinks.
Yeah, and it's a great spot too, which is weird because it seems further to the right, but I don't think it is just because the Minion stuff, because usually you can enter and exit here and there, but I don't know, we'll see. I'm happy to see it here, but there are some new spots that we will touch digging into the parks because I've never seen it there before.
Okay, so moving on through New York, we see another either food or drink booth. This was here multiple years before too, but this is just kind of like standard what has been the past few years. So just another option for food and drink. Okay, so we're just now making it into New York. and immediately you see a new, this is a, I believe it's the Killer Clowns truck that they had in back from 2018.
Yeah, we've seen this, I think, used a couple of times.
But it says Major Sweets Candy Co. So I think this fella is gonna be like the, I guess the like main icon for this scare zone. So I think that he's gonna play a big part. Killer Taste, Major Sweets Candy Company. I am so excited for this scare zone because I think it's really going to hit on all the major like Halloween, like traditional Halloween points. Here you can see all the corn stalks. There's a judge booth right here. Obviously somebody's gonna be up there either judging or doing some sort of scare. And then over here they have a tent. Obviously we covered this in our last video, but the tractor has crashed into the tent. And this is just very traditional Halloween. And I can't even explain how excited I am to see something like this come to Horror Nights. This is amazing.
This kind of reminds me of, I think it was 25 that had a scare zone like this. That was just like chaos. Traditional Halloween, it was like a pumpkin something festival, but it was like asylum related. So this isn't quite asylum related anything, but like maybe crazy candy something. I'm not really sure, but it looks good so far. We're not even seeing, I'm sure, like the half of it. It looks nice.
And we also noticed that the tribute store has not been completely taken down yet. It still has the summer tribute store look to it. But if you look at the windows right here, it says closed as if the actual theater itself, because that was kind of the theme for this, has actually been closed, like for, you know, if it was real. So this is kind of cool to see. And I'm sure we'll probably see a Halloween Horror Nights tribute store come up within the next couple weeks, so.
Yeah, but it seems like it's open for haunting.
The Mummy is still closed for refurbishments, but I have a good feeling that it might be open for Horror Nights, so. Coming to do some night rides on the Mummy might be possible, we'll see. So next to the Mummy, they also have some corn stalks. But I think I heard that this was actually bamboo, but I'm not sure. It actually feels pretty sturdy like bamboo. So anyways, but it looks like corn stalks. They have a corn stalk screen right here. Some unfortunate fellow right here who has met his demise. But this is going to be a very interesting scare zone. I'm very, very excited for this.
But what I think I'm even more interested in is what's going on in Sting Alley with all the meat. What's the meat?
Oh, I completely forgot. We're going to go check that out right now. So just along the side, if you're familiar with the New York area and Universal, they have a stage, or not stage, but they have an area right here that is, it looks like a meat market. It has the little like flaps for coolers right there. Some meat displayed right there. So we're going to walk in and see kind of like what they're trying to do up in here. As you can see, it looks like a genuine meat market. So I'm assuming this is gonna be a bar. I can't imagine. I mean, it looks like there's a little, you know, like area for like cookies and sweets and stuff like that. But I feel like overall, this is probably a good place for a bar, right? That little cooler right there.
With Universal, who knows? Like, really, truly, who knows? I'm so happy this space is being utilized.
We've been waiting forever for this, like, alleyway to be used for Horror Nights. And also down there, you can see there's, like, another booth set up. So I think this is going to be a very popular place for Halloween Horror Nights.
That we've never experienced. Sting Alley has never been used. Like, Nazarman Sting Alley has never been used. While we've been coming since 2016, 2017, so
I can't wait to see what this is gonna be. This is so exciting.
All right, so we're now looking at Louis right now, which before it was actually character dining was at Monsters Cafe. Why does it sound so wrong? I don't know. I guess we
because it's closed down now.
Yeah, and we've never been inside, and we've never done character dining. We've always wanted to, but around like I think $50 to $60, maybe about $55, is what it costs you to get into character dining. So it's been something I've always wanted to do, but just the added cost on top of the pass, it was never really worth it because there's so many food options. But it is this year in Louis. So maybe it's something we discuss later down the road if it's available. I first want to see, though, what kind of food, because our Wolfpack group, we've been talking about it. Is it worth it? Is it just pizza? Is it pasta? Is it other food? What is the added value besides just meeting this character? Which is really cool, but I mean, Universal makes it very accessible with the Scarezone, so I guess we're gonna have to see. But I guess stay tuned if we do that. I doubt this year is the year that we're gonna do it, but I don't know. I guess hang tight to see. I don't know.
Okay, so we're moving on into San Francisco. There's been a lot of updates since the last time that we were here. This is supposed to be some sort of witch-ish Scarezone, but from what I've seen, it looks like there's like Nordic symbols written on all of the props here, so I'm really kind of confused about what this is supposed to be.
Yep, but so there's a big cauldron, which we'll show you guys, but there's a lot of like, there's like a Nordic like wayfinding symbol that we'll show you, and a couple other things that we haven't seen yet. So
all right, so walking through, you immediately see some lighting trusses here, and then across is kind of like the main stage that they've had set up right now. That's kind of like the biggest, I guess, prop that they have. It's kind of dark, so I'm not sure if you can see it completely, but there's a lot of like Nordic looking symbols. I really hope you can see this because it's so dark. But there's a lot of like kind of weird Nordic symbols on it. I'm sure somebody's gonna be up here doing some sort of like presentation, some sort of scare. There is a big cauldron right here as well. So maybe the whole witch's theory is gonna come to fruition, I don't know.
Yeah, the spec have like feelings of this being like coven witches or witches, but it's very Nordic feeling too with all the runes and wayfinding, so that's just another thing that we're just gonna have to wait and see kind of what comes to be.
But other than that, there's really not too much change to San Francisco, just a lot of lighting rigs, and I guess we just have to wait and see. Okay, so around the side of Lombards in San Francisco, we actually noticed that there is an actual bar back here, which we haven't seen. Maybe this was here in like past Hornites, but from the time that we've been coming since 2017, we have not seen this.
Way back here, because like for I think Mardi Gras and Christmas there was like stuff right here, which there's a little sign, but there's ruins, old ruins over here, and then it pulls back, which looks like it's supposed to be a full bar, which normally there isn't, but I don't know. I mean, we'll see, but you see those little Nordic ruins, a lot of Nordic stuff.
Yeah, right over here too, and there
I should say I'm not a master at ruins, I don't know.
Take runology?
Yeah. But I don't know, it's pretty cool. Very, very sharp looking, but multiple shelves usually means multiple liquors. So hopefully that means a full bar over here too, which usually like Shea Alcatraz, Finnegan's, maybe Duff is really the only full bar. So it looks like they're trying to expand where you can get liquor drinks, I guess, throughout. So, I mean, I think they know their crowd and what they're playing to.
And I feel like people aren't going to be expecting this too. So this is going to be a very short line, I feel like, compared to most drink stands or food stands. So
we've never been back.
This is a first. This is a first.
I think it's going to be easy to blend in unless the line goes back. This really might be a nice place to like slip in, because like you could just see across the little lagoon over there, you see that big pumpkin. It draws you in, which that's where there was like that like pumpkin-y, scarecrow-y like thing last year that was right there. So I don't know. I mean, it's going to be very interesting to see how this lays out, because we really haven't had this. So I'm happy. I'm very happy to see something new and a new layout. I don't know, just a couple more weeks, man, and then we're going to be like really seeing it.
We are dying right now for for updates.
I'm somebody who can't take like secrets or surprises, so I checked all the spec maps, speculation, rumors, everything. Whether it's true or not, I don't know. I like to let my like mind just go with it. I know other people aren't, so we do have a video coming up about one of these shows that hasn't been announced yet that we want to try to show you the playlist. That we very strongly think is going to be in the show. So we'll put a spoiler warning, but we'll be posting that probably in like a couple of days. So hang tight, subscribe.
So walking past the Fear Factor stage, we noticed that it looks like they're practicing for Nightmare Fuel. Okay, so across from London and then the Fear Factor stage, there's a couple new booths, and then they have this giant pumpkin booth right here that I'm assuming is just gonna have a lot of drinks and treats. And well, I guess we'll wait to see what it has. So we are currently walking through Springfield, and ahead of us it looks like there is it kind of reminds me of Chucky, honestly.
Chucky, good guys colors.
Yeah, very good guys colors, but there's a lot of blood splattered everywhere. So I think this is kind of a new location for a food booth as well. It's a little bit dark. You can see Nicole's flash on her camera, but it's a very good guys reminiscent. So this is going to be another good place for some treats, some snacks, some drinks. I'm excited. And then across from the booth that we were just at, there is another booth right here that's kind of, it's very, very Halloween heavy.
Yeah,
so you got the scarecrows, you got the pumpkin heads, the orange and white and black, very, very Halloween-y. So just another great food option and drinks, I'm sure. They have looks like a castle. Type food booth right here and here. Yeah, Dracula, monsters.
By Men in Black. But yeah, very castle-y for sure.
And this is over by the SpongeBob store pants where the pizza fries is going to be in the kids zone. And I'm sure there's going to be a couple houses right here as well, just like there were last year. So. Hopefully it's not too dark for you to see, but
that might give you that HHN feel.
Definitely does. Okay, so on our way out, we're about to walk into Hollywood, but just to touch, if you haven't been to the horror makeup show right here, this is an absolute gas. It's funny. There's some jumpy parts, but just a lot of fun. If you haven't been there, definitely check it out. But walking into Hollywood right now, it looks like there's a little bit of updates right now. There's they added some foliage,
statues.
Yeah, some statues, some foliage to the props that were already there.
Yeah, the cemetery feel is real.
Yes, the cemetery feel is definitely real. And I cannot wait to see what they do with like the actual like pavement here. I'm hoping there's gonna be like some smoke like rising up, some fog machines that push smoke out in here and kind of make it a little bit more eerie. There's another like tree right over here, some more statues. I mean, this might be my favorite scare zone. I don't know, it's really hard to say it right now, but everything looks so good, so Halloween. I just cannot wait to see the final product. Excellent.
Yeah.
Okay, so we are clearly back home now. We are not at Universal Studios. We were gonna do an outro at the theme parks, mm-hmm. but it started to pour down rain.
In true Florida form.
Mm-hmm. Right when we were kind of like finishing up, so we decided just to come home, do our outro here. But overall, we just wanted to just give like an overall like view of what is new for Halloween Horror Nights, like the new setups and everything, what's going on. Mm-hmm. And this might be our last update video until the actual event starts. We might do one more, but...
Yeah, I'm hoping for one or two more.
But overall, I mean, we're just very excited for the event to... Mm-hmm. kick off.
Cannot wait.
But is there anything you want to add?
No, I don't think so. I'm just excited. When I said no, I meant yes. The biggest thing that I'm excited for, and it's super silly, the new placement of bars in Sting Alley, like by Nazarman's in New York, and San Francisco, the bar in the back where it's kind of tucked away. I'm very excited for that. I don't know if that's just because we haven't gotten any other updates or official announcements, but man, I'm really, really excited for that. So that being said, these next like week, 2 weeks are going to be so telling for the event. And I can't wait to go.
Yeah. But with that being said, mm-hmm. We're going to close it down. And if you liked the video, please subscribe. And we'll see you in the next video.
Do it. Bye.